There's a light shining bright in a cabin, and I know that it's shining for me. And I know that my mother is waiting for the boy she is longing to see. When it's
landing time in the valley,
and in dreams I go back to my home, I can see that old light in the window.
Thank you. Oh, Now let that E harp.
Lindale Train.
Thank you.
Hers is the voice I hear.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad farewells will there be spoken, and time will never be me.
Heaven. Yeah. I'll do that one for you when we come in, yeah, right after you get through. Black lab, and the dog's name was Tar. And he was telling me one day, he said, "Old Tar was a good dog." Said he was the kind of dog. This are full cell phones now. Said they could tie a note around old Tar's neck and send him down the street to his mother-in-law's house, and to take a message if they wanted to. And if mother-in-law had baked any cookies, she'd tie them around old Tar's neck, and he'd bring them home. I said, "I was raised out in the country and we had dogs, but I promise you if you ever tied a bag of cookies around his neck, it wasn't coming home with him." But anyway, that's just the kind of dog old Tar was. And he said he bought old Tar a rawhide bone. And he said he took that brand new bone and went out in the backyard and started digging a hole and was going to bury it. And he said, "I tapped on the window to get his attention. I hate to see him bury that new bone." And he said, "That dog looked up at me with a look on his face like, 'What business is it of yours? This is my bone, you know.'" And he was just telling me that story. He thought it was so funny the way that dog responded when he tried to get him to stop burying that bone. So I thought, well, there's got to be some kind of message there. Get in the key of G and let's do and play something like Amazing Grace. And I'll tell you the story of old Tar. I had an old dog, his name was Tar. I used to think, "My, how lucky you are. Not a care in the world, just lay around and sleep. Never have to worry about something to eat." Then I got to thinking, he's got nothing of his own. So I went out and I bought him an old rawhide bone. Well, he chewed and he wallered and he played on the floor. Picked up that old bone and he headed for the door. Well, he dug him a hole about 6 inches deep. He was going to bury that old bone just for the I tapped on the window with a look of disgust. Picked up that old bone, seen there was no one he could trust. Well, he buried the old bone, I know not where, and he came back in the house and just laid down there. But he just couldn't rest. His peace and contentment was gone. He just laid there worried about that old raw-eyed bone. Well, I've known a lot of folks who didn't hardly have a dime. Seemed like they was happy most all the time. You know, old tar, you're a whole lot like we. Work so hard to get something to keep. Buy a lot of things that we think is a must. Soon learn we don't own them. They really own us. For we have to guard and protect and try to maintain. Soon find that happiness is just not in things. True happiness comes down from above. And if we'll let him, God can fill all our hearts with peace, joy, contentment, love. So when I get to worrying about the things that I own, I just stop and think about old Tar and that rawhide bone.
Is that right?
I keep playing with these guys.
All right. Everywhere I go, the Lord is always with me. Everywhere I go, he's right there by my side. Constantly cheering me, pressing toward the victory. He is always. Climbing up that mountain, searching for that city.
but now the future.